Hi, my name is Jared, and in this bootcamp tutorial, we're going to give you a basic introduction to pairs trading using an SMA and a standard deviation indicator to monitor for variance in the spread of two assets. We're going to introduce what pairs trading is, what co-integration is, and implement this in the simplest way possible in QuantConnect. So let's get started. Pairs trading is when you look at the price difference between two assets and then monitor them for when there's a deviation or an abnormality in that price difference. The idea is that if the two stocks divert to an abnormally large difference or spread, that they will probably revert back to the same price difference they were before. And in the same way, if they narrow the spread or the price difference between the two assets, that the spread will probably widen. So the core theory is that the two assets have certain values and that when those values divert abnormally, that they will probably revert to their previous values. This works best with assets which have some core value proposition that's the same. Common examples are Coke and Pepsi, where they might be influenced by the same customer sentiment about health and sugar, the same taxes on soft drinks. They're also influenced by seasonality. When it's warm, people drink more. And so you could see the prices of these two companies probably will be co-integrated. We're going to use Coke and Pepsi for this example, but in reality, you probably wouldn't hard code your list of pairs trading stocks. You'd probably use some system to determine which assets to trade. So that would be best done in a universe selection model, as we learned in the last bootcamp tutorial about the algorithm framework. But just for simplicity, we're going to be using just hard-coded Coke and Pepsi. So a core requirement of a pairs trading strategy is that the assets which you're trading are co-integrated. This means that the price difference between the two assets should mean revert over time. So here we're just going to use the symbol create method. Security type and the equity market. And create for both Coke and Pepsi. Okay. Now add our manual universe. Create a new instance of our manual universe selection model. Okay, great. So now, as we did before, we want to change the resolution of our algorithm to be owl. So now, Pepsi and Coke will be added to our algorithm at hourly resolution. So now we should be ready to start looking for the price differences and performing our pairs trading analysis. Okay, great. On to the next one. It's common in pairs trading to create something called a synthetic asset, which is the price difference between the two assets that we're trading. So in this case, Coke and Pepsi will have prices, and then we'll subtract one from the other to get the spread or the price difference between them. So you can see on this demonstration here, you can imagine one's Coke and one's Pepsi. And as there's a fixed difference between the two prices, the spread here on the curve down below is at approximately -4. And then when the prices converge, it crosses zero and the spread goes positive again. We're going to create an alpha model that's looking for the spread. So let's create this alpha model here. And we can't assume we know which assets are being passed in, so we need to set up the infrastructure to use the assets which are added to our algorithm. We're going to create an empty list to hold the different securities. And we're going to initialize this list with securities which are added to the algorithm. So you can see here in the side, the nice helper, which will create a Python list of the securities, and save it to the self.pair. Now, finally, we need to calculate the spread between the two assets, and we can do that using our nice security storage here. We've got the spread is equal to the price of the first security minus the price of the second security. Under the hood here, the changes that get passed in, there's added securities and removed securities. And so you can access all of the properties of the security. Let's submit that and see how we go. Okay, great. On to the next task. Now, really, to monitor for differences in the spread, it's best to use the standard deviation of the spread of that asset. There are many different ways of doing this. We're just going to demonstrate a nice simple way to do it in QuantConnect. Here, in the constructor of the pairs trading alpha model, we want to create a moving average for the spread of those two assets, and then a standard deviation indicator for the deviation of the spread. Let's create those two indicators here. And we're going to create a 500 bar simple moving average and a 500 bar standard deviation. Okay, great. Now we've got two indicator objects. We need to update them with real price data. So let's do that here. Indicators take time and a value. So we're going to need the time of this indicator price data point, and then the value that we want to update it with. So for this, we have this spread, that's the value, and the time, we can use the algorithm object that's passed in here, and the time property on that. Now we want to do almost identically the same with the standard deviation indicator. So here we're calculating the mean of the spread between those two assets and then the standard deviation of the spread of those two assets. So when the spread moves outside of a normal range, we want to know that and then place trades accordingly. Using our mean and our standard deviation, we can calculate an upper threshold and a lower threshold for what that normal might be. So here we've got some helper variables, along with the helper calculation here. And then the lower threshold is here. So this upper threshold is the mean plus the standard deviation, and then the lower threshold is the mean minus the standard deviation. So when the spread goes too wide or when the spread goes too narrow, we want to trade. We've created our indicator, we've created the standard deviation indicator, we've updated them, and now I've created our upper and lower thresholds. Let's see how we go. Okay, great. On to the next task. In this task, we're going to look into the trading, emitting the insights for this signal. If you remember, we were looking if the spread had gone outside of the upper threshold or if the spread had gone below the lower threshold. We can look at that spread value and then emit insights accordingly. With pairs trading, you want to emit the insights as a group. The two insights should be traded simultaneously. One of the insights will go long and the other one will go short, and it's betting that they will mean revert. So which one you long and which one you short depends on whether the spread is greater than normal or less than normal. We're using these helpers here. We can look to see if the spread that we've calculated currently is greater than the standard deviation plus the mean or the upper threshold. And in that case, we're betting that one of them is going to go up and the other one's going to go down to narrow the spread to get it back to normal ranges. Conversely, if the spread is lower than its lower threshold, we think that it's going to widen, and so we'll bet the opposite. And then finally here at the bottom, if the spread is in between, the upper and lower threshold don't do anything. There's no need to trade, and we don't have any confidence that it's going to mean revert. It's just within its normal ranges. These insights are going to be emitted, and then the execution of those will be handled by the immediate execution model and the equal weighting portfolio construction model. One piece which is notably missing from this task is that the calculation of those positions should be an equal cash weighting. Oftentimes the two securities might be co-integrated, but they might have different prices, and you need to calculate the equal weighting in each asset, not just 100 shares of both assets. So that's handled for you by the equal weighting portfolio construction model. Underneath the hood there, it says that you've got two insights, one for Coke, one for Pepsi, and it will allocate 50% of your portfolio to each one. And it will calculate the number of shares that means that equates to. The last part here is doing some logging so we can see what our algorithm is doing. Oh, and one part here. If you see here, we've emitted the insight group. So we want those two trades to be emitted at the same time. And we've emitted it on a period of 2 hours. The 2 hour period is fairly arbitrary. You should set your period according to the data that you're using or according to your strength and the prediction confidence. In this case, we're saying that we're looking at hourly data. We're noting that it's a deviation, but it's only one standard deviation away from the norm. So we're just setting it to a period of 2 hours, which is roughly on the order of the data that we're using. So we're going to set self.period here equal to the time span, time delta, 2 hours. And then we're going to do some logging. Just to see our portfolio quantity. The on end of day is a helper method here, and you can see that it takes a symbol, it's passed a symbol object. This means the end of the day for that symbol. So in this case, we're able to use that symbol and then generate a log of the portfolio quantity for that symbol, and it can help us in debugging the algorithm. Okay, see how we go. Okay, we did it. On to the next one. Like all of the other indicators we've used, you need to warm them up to prepare them to be used. So in this case, we're using the mean and the standard deviation of the spread. We need to request the historical data for those assets, calculate the spread, and then update the indicators with that spread. Let's first do the history call to get the historical data for the assets that we're looking at. You can see here we're using x.symbol in self.pair because the self.pair was the security objects, and so we want to extract the symbol to make the history call. And then we're asking for 500 units here, and it's defaulting to the resolution of the securities. And in this case, our universe has a resolution of hour. We're going to be getting 500 hours of historical data, and then we need to use the unstack to just simplify that data frame down to the close properties. Okay, now finally we've got a nice simple data frame, we've got the historical data, let's iterate through it and then update the indicators. Use this helper code here. Tuple 0 is the time index, and then 2 and 1 are the security prices, the close prices. So by saying tuple 0, we're looking at the first column of that data frame, and then tuple 2 is the second security, and tuple 1 is the first, and so this is the spread between the close prices of those assets. So we want to update the mean and the standard deviation with the same value, and we can just pass that in like that when the security is added. And then this way, we should be ready to trade immediately as soon as the algorithm starts. So let's submit that and see how we go. Okay, great. Congratulations, you've passed the Pairs Trading with SMH Bootcamp tutorial. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.